A logo for the CDC appears featuring an abstract bird made of human faces in profile. Department of Health and Human Services, USA.
Welcome back to our video series on evaluating health adaptation for a changing climate. In this video, we illustrate evaluation best practices for describing health adaptation work using our real-world scenarios.
Describing the program appears on screen across an illustrated model of the United States.
Describing the program is the second step in the CDC evaluation framework. In this step, we describe clearly what our program does and depict visually with a logic model the outcomes we expect to achieve as a result of our activities.
Standards utility, feasibility, propriety, and accuracy appear in the center of the screen, surrounded by a ring with six sections. Engage stakeholders, describe the program, focus evaluation design, gather credible evidence, justify conclusions, and ensure use and share lessons.
In step two, stakeholders use a participatory process to create a logic model, which visualizes how a health adaptation is expected to work.
A logic model appears on screen. Three white boxes labeled inputs comprise column one. Three arrows point to three white boxes in column two labeled activities. Two arrows point to two white boxes in column three labeled outputs. Two arrows point to two blue boxes in column four labeled short-term outcomes. One arrow points to one blue box in column five labeled intermediate outcomes. One arrow points to one dark blue box in column six, labeled impact.
We know that health adaptations are complicated by time, scale, and complexity.
An illustrated orange ball sits on a timeline and then jumps to a matrix of blue, green, and yellow balls connected by lines. The orange ball jumps from blue to green balls along the lines. Two additional orange balls roll along three concentric circles.
Creating logic models to describe them is equally complicated. For example, simple logic models may suggest linearity and causality where it does not exist. Similarly, depicting complicated relationships or influential factors or conditions using logic models can be challenging.
A blank logic model with five columns of boxes appears on screen. A red X appears between the first and second columns, causing the adjacent boxes to turn yellow. A double-headed red arrow appears between the third and fourth columns, causing the adjacent boxes to turn yellow.
Overcoming challenges in illustrating complex health adaptation calls for following useful design practices such as using diverse design elements, integrating context, and making assumptions explicit. We can convey complicated adaptations in a number of ways, like placing time or scale boundaries in and around our model.
The logic model appears on screen below the title, Use Diverse Design Elements. Below the logic model, an orange timeline labeled Years appears with an arrow pointing to the right. A dotted line encircles the short-term outcomes column and is labeled Neighborhood. Another dotted line encircles the short-term outcomes and intermediate outcomes columns and is labeled County. A third dotted line encircles the previous columns as well as the Impact column and is labeled State.
Using different types of lines and arrows allows us to show relationships and the strength of those relationships. A bolder or more solid line can convey a stronger relationship or hypothesized relationship between the items in the boxes.
On the left, three boxes are labeled intermediate outcomes. On the right, two boxes are labeled impact. A dotted line box is located between the two columns labeled strength of relationship. A solid green line is drawn from column one to column two and labeled strong. A dashed orange line is drawn from column 1 to column 2 and labeled mixed. A dotted blue line is drawn from column 1 to column 2 and labeled unknown. In column 2, a dotted blue line is drawn between the top and bottom boxes and labeled impact.
Varying shades of color and different shapes or symbols can convey different categories or intensities of connections or relationships.
The logic model appears on screen. The boxes in column 2 change to green, blue, and orange with diamond, triangle, and oval symbols overlaying. The boxes in column 3, 4, and 5 each change to include one green box and one orange box each. The boxes in column 3 also include a diamond and oval shape overlaying the boxes. The box in column 6 changes to dark green.
It is also important to integrate context into the model. The context of an adaptation is critical in enabling or hindering activities, outputs, and outcomes. We can improve our evaluation by incorporating this information by, for instance, including projected climate data or vulnerability indices in our logic model if they are relevant.
An illustration of a funnel appears on screen. Confetti in varying shades of gray falls from the top of the screen into the funnel. As the confetti enters the funnel, the phrase adaptation context falls from the bottom. Four phrases fall into the funnel with the confetti including economic data, historic climate data, projection data, and vulnerability indices.
Finally, we can be very explicit in noting any assumptions we have between the boxes or nodes in our logic model. This will lead to insights about how our stakeholders expect the adaptation to work.
Make assumptions explicit appears on screen. A light blue box appears to the left of the screen labeled If This. An arrow is drawn to the right of the screen to a blue box labeled Then This. Y appears on screen below the boxes.
Let's now check in with our practitioners to see how they are using these practices to describe their health adaptations, the second step of the evaluation framework.
An illustrated woman, Cassandra, stands in front of the city health department. An illustrated woman, Elaine, stands in front of the state health department. An illustrated man, Jackson, stands in front of the county health department.
If you would like to revisit our practitioners' evaluation journeys so far, please refer back to the previous videos in this series. To describe the new city greening project, Cassandra's logic model uses two of our design principles. She is color-coding her outcomes and using rainfall projections to illustrate the project's potential impacts.
Cassandra stands next to a new logic model with four vertical colored sections, dark green, light green, light orange, and red. The top dark green box is labeled More Protective Outcomes. The bottom red box is labeled Less Protective Outcomes. An illustration of a funnel labeled City Rainfall Projections appears next to the logic model.
By color coding according to different projection scenarios, Cassandra is able to show stakeholders the different impacts they might expect to see with the greening project.
The logic model expands. A bracket to the left of the model is labeled Outputs. The top box reads, Most Stormwater Diverted. The second box reads, More Stormwater Diverted. The third box reads, Less Stormwater Diverted. The bottom box reads, Least Stormwater Diverted. An arrow coming from the top box points to the phrase, Least Rainfall Projection. An arrow coming from the bottom box points to the phrase, Most Rainfall Projection.
Further, this helps her explain how all outcomes in the logic model, especially health outcomes, may be affected by different rainfall levels.
The logic model expands again. The output box and bracket comprise the first column. The second column is labeled Early Outcomes and includes four light blue boxes labeled Most, More, Less, and Least Stormwater Diverted. The third and fourth columns are labeled Later Outcomes and include four boxes each, ranging in color from dark green to red. The boxes in column three are labeled Large Decrease, Slight Decrease, No Change, and Large Decrease in Sewage Overflows. The boxes in column 4 are labeled Large Decrease, Slight Decrease, No Change, and Large Increase in Waterborne Illnesses. An arrow coming from the top row of boxes points to the phrase Least Rainfall Projection. An arrow coming from the bottom row of boxes points to the phrase Most Rainfall Projection.
These design principles also help demonstrate the point at which greening may not effectively manage stormwater.
All of the boxes in the logic model lose their color aside from the third row of boxes, which remains orange.
For instance, if the city begins experiencing higher rainfall levels, then city officials may need to revisit decisions about the usefulness of greening for stormwater management.
An illustration of rain falling on a city rain garden appears on screen. Four illustrated people join Cassandra standing in front of the garden.
Instead, they may decide that resources should be redirected towards more sweeping efforts, such as installing larger pipes to better manage the volume of stormwater.
Rainwater enters the pipes of the city sewer system. The size of the pipe increases below ground, and the water spills out.
Meanwhile, at her state health department, Elaine continues her evaluation work on wildfire preparedness. She is using shapes and design elements to describe how the multi-tiered program crosses different scales.
Elaine stands next to a new logic model with five columns. Column one is labeled Interventions and includes three boxes labeled Outreach, Training, and Resource Assistance. Three arrows point to column two, which is labeled Outputs and includes three boxes, Distributed Messages, Completed Trainings, and Resources Provided. Two arrows point to column three, which is labeled Short-Term Outcomes Individual Scale and includes two boxes labeled Increased Knowledge of Risk and Protective Actions and Increase in Protective Actions. A downward-pointing arrow connects the two boxes in column three. One arrow points to column four, which is labeled Intermediate Outcomes County Scale and includes one box labeled Decrease in Exposure to Wildfire Smoke. One arrow points to column 5, which is labeled Long-Term Outcomes, State Scale, and includes one box which is labeled Decrease in Wildfire-Related Injuries and Illnesses. The Short-Term Outcomes column is encircled with a solid white line. This column, along with the Intermediate Outcomes column, is encircled in a dashed white line. These two columns, along with the Long-Term Outcomes column, are encircled in a dotted white line.
Because our program includes three major interventions, outreach, training, and resource assistance, Elaine updates her larger model to show how the interventions fit together.
A red diamond overlays the outreach and distributed messages boxes. A yellow rectangle overlays the training and completed trainings boxes. A green circle overlays the resource assistance and resources provided boxes.
She then breaks it into three intervention-specific logic models. To better describe each specific intervention, Elaine uses different shapes to create a separate, smaller logic model depicting how each intervention intends to achieve its specific outcomes.
A magnifying glass overlays the trainings box. This box is expanded into four columns. The first column is labeled Intervention Activities and includes one box labeled Develop and Conduct Trainings for At-Risk Populations. One arrow points from this column to column 2, which is labeled Outputs, and includes one box labeled Number of Trainings Provided at At-Risk Populations. One arrow points from this column to column 3, which is labeled Short-Term Outcomes, and includes two boxes labeled Percentage of At-Risk Populations with Increased Knowledge of Wildfire Risk and Percentage of At-Risk Populations with Increased Self-Efficacy for Taking Protective Actions. A downward-pointed arrow connects the two boxes in column 3. One arrow points from this column to column 4, which is labeled Intermediate Outcomes, and includes one box labeled Percentage of At-Risk Populations Reporting Increases in Protective Actions.
This nested approach provides a clearer picture of how the program is expected to work. This design also allows Elaine to show how data from different interventions can feed into the same outcome category, such as knowledge increase or behavior change.
The short-term outcomes column expands to reveal two interventions. The first intervention, outreach, is encircled in a dashed line. It includes two boxes labeled Percentage of At-Risk Populations Demonstrating Increases in Protective Actions and Percentage of At-Risk Populations Demonstrating Increased Knowledge of Wildfire Risk. The boxes are connected by a line and are overlaid by a diamond shape. The second intervention, trainings, is also encircled in a dashed line. It includes three boxes labeled Percentage of At-Risk Populations with Increased Knowledge of Wildfire Risk, Percentage of At-Risk Populations with Increased Self-Efficacy for Taking Protective Actions, and Percentage of At-Risk Populations Reporting Increases in Protective Actions. The boxes are connected by two arrows and are overlaid by a rectangle shape. Knowledge Increase appears under one box, and Behavior Change appears under box 3.
Now let's check in with Jackson at the County Health Department to see how his training evaluation plan is progressing. After engaging a few additional stakeholders, Jackson and the work group conduct a logic modeling session to map out how they expect their home health aid intervention to unfold.
Jackson stands in front of a whiteboard covered in many different colored sticky notes. Four stakeholders sit around a conference table with stacks of sticky notes and writing utensils.
They start by writing down all the activities and intended outcomes on sticky notes and placing them on the whiteboard to show how they think the program will work.
The whiteboard fills the screen and two sticky notes appear, a yellow sticky note labeled Activity 1 and a green sticky note labeled Outcome 1. The two sticky notes contract smaller to find their place in the logic model of the whiteboard.
Jackson then engages his group in a discussion about assumptions. For example, conducting trainings won't automatically lead to an increase in knowledge.
A pink sticky note appears on screen that reads, "If we conduct trainings with home health aides, why will they gain knowledge?" The pink sticky note contracts smaller to its place in the logic model.
Underlying factors often hold our logic model pieces together. The group works to identify underlying assumptions between two key outcomes, home health aides' increase in knowledge and the adoption of a new behavior, such as identifying symptoms of heat-related illness.
A dashed line is drawn from the yellow to the green sticky note, which now reads, "Home health aides increase knowledge on heat-related illnesses." A dashed line is drawn to a second green sticky note that reads, "Home health aides identify symptoms of heat-related illnesses." A second pink sticky note appears that reads, "If home health aides' knowledge increases, why will they be able to identify symptoms of heat-related illness?"
As the group begins examining the various parts of the logic model and generating their assumptions, they ask themselves, to what extent are these assumptions valid? Following one of the design principles, Jackson suggests making these assumptions explicit in the logic model by using dashed lines to show the areas of uncertainty.
A logic model appears on screen with five columns. Column 1 is labeled Train Home Health Aides and includes an arrow pointing to column 2. Column 2 reads Increase Knowledge. Two dashed lines, A and B, are drawn from the second column to two boxes in column 3 labeled Identify Heat Illness and Prevent Heat Exposure. An arrow drawn from the first box bypasses column 4 and points to column 5. An arrow is drawn from the second box in column 3 to column 4, which reads Reduce Effects. An arrow is drawn from column 4 to column 5, which reads Reduce Heat Illness.
To further capture the discussion, he adds notes to make their assumptions explicit and places them at the bottom of the final logic model. Clearly noting this information will help the group decide on an appropriate set of standards and indicators later on in the evaluation process.
A list titled Assumptions appears below the logic model. The first assumption is, aides are with clients while they're experiencing heat-related illness symptoms. The second assumption is, clients are receptive to aides' suggestions for symptomatic control / treatment.
Using the best practices described in this video can allow you to tackle common challenges faced by practitioners in step 2 of the evaluation framework.
The various logic models discussed in this video appear on screen.
CDC provides many useful resources on describing programs. For more information, please visit our Climate and Health Evaluation webpage.
An illustration of a computer monitor appears on screen displaying the CDC website, open to a section titled Climate and Health Evaluation Video Series.
In the following video, our three practitioners will begin step 3 of the evaluation cycle, focusing the evaluation design for their health adaptation work.
An illustration of another computer monitor appears on screen that reads, Focusing Your Design.